From missions to cultural issues, this is Grace Talk, a ministry of Grace Baptist Church. Here's your host, Pastor Michael West.
Welcome to Grace Talk. Today it's a privilege to have Dr. Paul Chitwood joining us with today's discussion about missions. Dr. Paul Chitwood is former executive director of the Kentucky Baptist Convention. He spent 18 plus years, pastoring churches in and around Kentucky. And he also holds both an MDiv and PhD from the Southern Baptist Theological Seminary, and he currently serves as president of the International Mission Board. Dr. Paul Chitwood, thanks for joining us today on Grace Talk. I really appreciate you taking the time out of your busy schedule and joining us today.
No, thanks for the opportunity. Glad to be connecting with you. Appreciate Grace Baptist so much and all that you as a church family do and have been doing, not only to support the missionaries through the IMB with your giving and your praying, but also going and serving alongside of us and cooperative program giving and Lottie Moon Christmas Offering. We are incredibly grateful for this church family.
Thank you, Dr. Paul Chitwood. One thing I want to just kind of kick this off with is just talk about, first of all, what your life has been like since you went to the IMB. What is it? About a year now that you've been there, and you know, what's that been like for you? I'm sure it's crazy, but maybe you could just kind of inform us on what your daily grind is like being president of the International Mission Board.
Yeah, well, the way I describe it is I had 48 years of life, and now I have a new life, and it's a different life, and there really is very little that of this new life and my new role that resembles the life I lived for 48 years. So it's entirely different life in every way, but we feel so blessed and privileged to have the opportunity. Michelle is just doing a great job serving my wife, serving alongside me, and helping us connect with the missionaries, reconnect with Southern Baptists, and again, just thankful to have the opportunity. But day to day, so over the last been almost 13 months, and as of 2 a.m. this morning when I got off a flight from California. I think that was flight number 144 since I've been in the role. I've been overseas six times, heading back again to Spain at the end of this month, and then traveled a lot in the States to speak in churches and state conventions and meetings and gatherings. We're really in the role to, the way I put it to our missionaries, is to do everything we can do to ensure they can do what God has called them to do. So our missionaries need a strong supporting organization. They need the financial resources to be able to stay on the field and do their work. They need partners, local churches like Grace and state conventions like Kentucky Baptist Convention, and all of our SBC family to be able to do what they do and help us as Southern Baptists do all that we do when we're working together through cooperative mission efforts overseas. And so I'm in the role, Michelle and I have come into this role to make sure that we keep strong connections to the missionaries and to the churches, to make sure that the resources that they need, they're able to have. We're in a position, thankfully, where we can begin to grow our number of missionaries on the field again. And so we're working hard to let Southern Baptists know there's opportunities to go through the IMB. All in all, though it's a very different life, it's a wonderfully blessed life.
Yeah, amen. Yeah, I think that's a good segue into our next question is, you know, it's this month, December, is Lottie Moon Christmas Offering. And we're all Southern Baptist churches across the United States are being challenged to give to that. Would you take a few minutes just kind of speak to who was Lottie Moon? I think a lot of people don't really know who she was and why we give to that. What's the importance of giving to the Lottie Moon Christmas Offering?
So the Lottie Moon Christmas Offering 100% is used to support our work among the nations. We have 3,700 missionaries and their 2,880 kids who are sharing the gospel around the world, and 100% of the gifts given through the Lottie Moon Christmas Offering go to support their work overseas. That Christmas offering is named after one of our earliest female missionaries who went out as a single, Lottie Moon. She's from Virginia. In fact, I had the opportunity next Sunday to preach in her home church in Charlottesville. But she went out in 1872. She spent 39 years serving among the people of China. There, sharing the gospel and pouring out her life. She was known to Southern Baptists as a fierce advocate for the mission work in China. And she was constantly making appeals to Southern Baptists to do more in terms of giving more generously to the work, knowing how many lost were among the nations. She was a fierce advocate for the mission of God and a voice for calling out other missionaries that God used. She, after 39 years of service, near the end of her ministry, was serving in a time of horrible famine in China. She shared much of her food and means with Chinese people who were literally starving to death. Over time, there were consequences to her health that were severe and continued to grow until they insisted that she return home. So she boarded a boat to come home, actually died on the passage back here to the States after serving for those 39 years. Southern Baptists later named their international missions offering in her honor. And to date, there have been over $5 billion that have been collected in honor of Lottie Moon to take her to the ends of the earth.
Wow. And so you mentioned how the Lottie Moon Christmas offering, it's 100% going to the field. Can you kind of elaborate on, you know, what kind of needs that meets when it goes out to the field, to the missionaries, what it helps them with, you know, whether it's housing or whatever?
Yes, very good. So, you know, our missionaries who serve on behalf of Southern Baptists to the International Mission Board are blessed in that they don't have to raise funds on their own. They're provided for, their ministry, their living expenses are provided for through the generosity of Southern Baptist giving, through the Lottie Moon Christmas offering and the cooperative program. So our missionaries have a home to live in, they have vehicles to drive, they have ministry budgets, they have food to eat, transportation, all of those needs met. And so they don't have to worry about where the support will come from, because Southern Baptists continue to faithfully give. The results of that work are staggering, really. There were over 13,000, almost 14,000 new churches that were planted this past year.
Wow.
Through our IMB missionaries and their Baptist partners overseas. And that's a direct investment of churches like Grace Baptist and individual members who put their offering in the offering plate to support that work. Those missionaries are working in refugee settlements. We had the opportunity to visit in May to a refugee, no, it was in April, the refugee settlement in Uganda, and see the impact that was being made there among refugees. There was an orphanage that we visited. That orphanage, orphan care is taking place there. Really, any mission work that you can imagine doing is being done through Southern Baptist International Mission Board missionaries. And that is a direct result of the generosity of Southern Baptists who give every year through the Lottie Moon Christmas offering.
Yeah, so that's good. So, I mean, it just kind of relieves them of the burden of having to worry about what they're going to eat, how they're going to get there, where they're going to live. That's taken care of so they can be free to share the gospel, to advance the gospel around the world. So, I mean, that's great. Good feedback on that. One thing I wanted to mention to you, in October, some stats came out from the International Mission Board, and it was kind of staggering to me to just see the numbers. You know, when you see the numbers of unreached peoples and how many that accounts for, it's pretty staggering to think about that there are 7,092 unreached people groups around the world right now, which accounts for 4 billion people. And so, you know, I want to just kind of hear your heart, you know, as president of the International Mission Board, you know, what is your vision? What are your thoughts moving forward and, you know, advancing the gospel in, into those areas of the world that people are unreached?
Well, we're driven by the vision of Revelation 7:9. In fact, that is our vision statement as an organization. We adopted that back in 2009 when I was a trustee and not the president. But if you're familiar with that passage, John is able to see a glimpse into heaven and have a vision of heaven. And in that vision, he says he saw a great multitude that no one could number from all tribes, from every nation, people, and language of the world, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They're there worshiping him. Now, we know that if the Lord Jesus were to return today to claim his church, the vision of heaven would not yet be fulfilled, because there are still some tribes, some nations, some people, some languages that would not be represented around the throne, because no one has yet been reached. What drives us as an organization every day, what drives our missionaries to stay on the field, deal with the challenges they're dealing with, and continue in their work, is that we know the vision of heaven will be fulfilled.
Absolutely.
And God has given us the privilege of being the avenue by which it will be fulfilled, using us to have our part in seeing the lost reach and those and nations, peoples, languages, and tribes represented around his throne will be worshiping with him for eternity, knowing that there are so many yet unreached. There is much work yet to be done. We are thankfully in a position to begin to grow our missionary force again. And we've actually set a goal, you know, with 2020 representing the 175th anniversary of the IMB, and 2025 will be the 100th anniversary of the cooperative program. So there's a 5-year window in there we're vision casting for our work. And one of the things that we want to see is our missionary force grow by 500 over those 5 years, 100 more each year under appointment. We get those numbers based upon talking with our field leadership teams and how many more missionaries. I ask them a very simple question: how many more missionaries do you need on your teams to have the minimum number of missionaries who are making the maximum impact for the opportunities that God has set in front of you today? And adding those up from the different places in the world where leadership teams are working, the total was 500. So it's our goal to see us grow. Now, that's going to take more missionaries answering the call of God. It's going to take more giving and certainly more praying. And we're asking Southern Baptists to join us in praying that God would provide what is needed. What we know at the end of the day is the greatest resource in the Great Commission is not our money. It's not even our missionaries. The greatest resource in the Great Commission is the Holy Spirit of God.
Amen.
Our money doesn't have the ability to save anybody. Our missionaries don't have the ability to save anybody.
Yeah.
But the Spirit of God does. Mm. How do we access the Spirit of God? How do we utilize that power, that great resource? It's through prayer.
Yeah.
So the prayer support that Southern Baptists give, and thank you, Grace Baptist, for praying for your missionaries and for the lost among the nations, that is as vital a support as we could possibly have. And we're hoping to see more Southern Baptists mobilized and praying daily for our missionaries and for the work.
That's good. Yeah, one of the things just in my heart, you know, for Grace Baptist and our people here is that God would just begin raising up people to just abandon everything and commit themselves to the field, to advancing the gospel. Maybe just spend a few minutes just talking about how does one become a missionary with the International Mission Board? What does that look like going through that process?
Yeah, so we are hiring today. We have budgeted jobs, unfilled positions around the world. So the way that process begins is with an individual feeling the call of God upon their heart and upon their life, and having that being confirmed by their reading in scripture and walking through that with their faith family. Then simply make contact with the IMB. You can do that on our website at imb.org, and there is a going tab, and you can fill an application. right online in just a few minutes, and one of our representatives from IMB will reach out to you and begin to talk you through and walk you through the process of becoming a candidate to be a missionary to the IMB. If you don't like filling out online forms, just give a call. Our number is there on the website, and someone will connect with you and, again, talk through that with you and help walk through it with you. And there's a process, you know, of meeting qualifications and going through spiritual formation with your church family, just to make sure that, that you, as a person who's going to live cross-culturally and going to be in the heat of the spiritual warfare, that you're ready physically, emotionally, spiritually to go. That process, overall, the appointment process from beginning to end, if you, stay at it, it takes about 10 to 12 months. So it's not something that happens overnight, and it's a pretty rigorous process. But at the end of the day, that pays great dividends, because people who may have a heart for the nations, but are not ready yet to go and live their lives overseas and do ministry across culture for the long haul, they don't end up going before the time is right. But others are able to show that, hey, the time is right now, and we're pleased to send.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. So let's just kind of wrap up here with this thought. What advice would you give to the local church on how to be better connected and informed about what's going on in the field? And I want to just kind of say this around that. You know, unless a church has someone out of their church that's a missionary that's out in the field, you know, they obviously are hearing what's going on and have a little more access to it. You know, some churches may not have anyone they know that's connected out in the field, so therefore they're kind of somewhat disconnected from what's happening in the world. So what advice would you give to, you know, how can we better shore that up? That churches, a local church, is better informed about what's happening in the field?
Yeah, that's a great question. I love that question, because we want to see Southern Baptists more engaged, and there's a desperate need for Southern Baptists to be more directly engaged in the work. So for those who have access to online social media, you can at our website actually sign up for daily prayer requests that provide you information with unreached people groups, provide you information about the work that the IMB missionaries are doing, so you can then pray with us for those needs and those opportunities. And that is a great connecting point. In addition to that, there are lots of partnership opportunities where a church can be in direct partnership with a missionary or a missionary team, where they're getting regular updates from the field. If church is looking to establish those partnerships, you can just call the IMB. We have what we call the Church Success Center. And the Church Success Center will help provide the materials and the connections to get the church dialed in. But churches can adopt unreached people groups. And at any level, whether that means that you as a church are emphasizing praying for them, or you're connecting with missionaries on the field, you're trying to reach them, or your church accepts responsibility of being the missionary presence in some way where there is not a missionary targeting that unreached people group, where you're taking regular mission trips or helping work with any national believers in the area, we can help connect you to. In addition to the things I've shared online, there's lots of video resources for church. I know there are churches that show a quick video every Sunday or one Sunday a month to keep the church informed about the missionaries, keep them connected to their mission work. One of the challenges in the way we do missions at Southern Baptist, while we can do far more together than we can ever do on our own, one of the challenges is that missionaries who don't go out from your church, as you mentioned, Jeff, if a church doesn't have a missionary from their church, the personalization of that, the feel of a personal connection to the missionary, can be harder to achieve. And so some people say, well, the cooperative program at the IMB, there's not a name, there's not a face to that. Well, there are thousands of names and thousands of faces. And we have the largest missionary sending agency of its kind in the history of Christianity that has been able to be built because Southern Baptists have been committed to working together. And we're working harder to try to keep Southern Baptists connected. Yeah. We just rebuilt our communications team. There's lots of articles in Baptist Press Kentucky Baptist Convention gives access to those as well. So just those opportunities to come to a greater awareness. And listen, we'd invite anyone who wants to come up from Grace Baptist to visit the International Mission Board, our headquarters, our learning center here, and be able to see. You can volunteer and serve here. As well as go serve among our missionaries among the nations.
Yeah, that sounds good. We may have to take you up on that offer to come out and visit with you. And you know, as we just wind down here, I just want to say thank you for joining us today on this podcast. I think it's going to be very beneficial to those who are listening to it, just to be more informed about missions, what the offering goes to, and how many missionaries are out on the field, you know, the unreached peoples. And so I appreciate your time today and just taking a little bit of your time to talk about that. And I want to let you know also, man, I'm excited about you going to be here in March for our missions conference to kick that off. And so we're excited about that. There's a lot of people in our church that are very excited about you coming too. So we look forward to seeing you in March of 2020.
Well, thank you. It's been good to spend time with you today. And I guess the thought I would leave you with is that according to the research that we've just got through some of the results from, there are 155,252 lost people who die every day among the nations. 155,252.
Wow.
That's why the IMB exists. Mm. That's why Southern Baptists work together. That's the problem we're addressing. There's no more pressing problem in the world than that problem. And we're thankful to be in partnership with Grace Baptist to see more of those lost people saved.
Amen. Very good. Very good. All right, brother. Thanks for joining us, man.
Thank you. God bless.